It is now day 10 of Iceland's latest eruption of the Reykjanes volcano. One recent major development is that freshly erupted lava in the active lava flows has turned from going straight south and instead is heading westwards. This places the expanding lava field's most active lobe north of both the town of Grindavik and the dirt wall which is protecting it. However, this expansion, which has, in the last 48 hours, covered an additional 0.1 square kilometers or 24.7 acres, has created a new problem, albeit a logistical one. Specifically, lava is now actively pouring into and filling what is called the Meholz mine. While this mine was originally closed, it was temporarily reopened during November of last year to be utilized as a primary source of scoria and volcanic rock in the construction of protective lava barriers. With the mine being partially filled by molten rock, especially in its lowest points, this is no longer possible. As a result, construction workers will have to travel further to source relevant rocks which will be needed to reinforce and increase the height of existing lava walls. Lava has indeed overtopped the lowest of these walls, specifically the 4-meter or 13.1 foot tall ones via the method being shown on screen. It has not spilled over quite yet, but this could technically occur before the walls are increased to 9 meters in height. The next few days are crucial, as once again lava flows specifically to the north of Grindavik will place additional strain on that set of lava walls. Whether or not these fail and fresh lava starts flowing into Grindavik proper will be decided by both random chance and the hard work of workers and volunteers to quickly fill in any gaps in sections of the wall which get breached. The most at-risk segments involves anything above a paved road, although lava from the current eruption has thankfully not yet reached a specific prior point of failure which occurred in January. In total, an estimated 25.5 million cubic meters of molten rock, or enough to fill 10,200 Olympic-sized swimming pools, has erupted since March 16th, covering a total of 5.86 square kilometers or 2.26 square miles. In other words, the average lava flow thickness is now 4.35 meters or 14.3 feet. You might be wondering why, if the current eruption is fairly stable, that tourists and the public alike have not been granted access to view the eruption up close. The answer involves safety issues, security concerns, and logistics. During the three eruptions of the neighboring Fagradalsfjall volcano further to the east from 2021 to 2023, people could within reason get right up close next to an eruption. However, Iceland's emergency services were always on standby and had gas meters to quickly get everyone out of an area when gas levels reached too high. This meant never allowing people to go downwind, only upwind of the eruption. And since the three main potentially deadly volcanic gases are heavier than air, they pool at natural low points. This means any safe viewing areas must have a decent height above the eruption site. The current eruption does not offer this. While there is an old shield volcano vent 500 meters southeast of the still erupting 7 vents, sections of it are only 1 to 20 meters above the erupting vents. Compare this to the 2022 Fagradalsfjall eruption where viewing areas were 100 meters above the erupting fissures. However, even the specified area southeast of Reykjanes would not be safe, as note the cooling lava flow towards the east. This is actively releasing hydrogen sulfide, carbon dioxide, and sulfur dioxide, which is largely blowing towards the west, going over and onto the old shield volcano vent I just mentioned. The second problem relates to Grindavik being closed off to tourists. Keeping all non-residents out has already proven to be an issue, and there is not currently spare cash or the will to hire additional security to keep those who stray too close to what is considered an unsafe area out. When you combine this with the fact that the ongoing eruption has produced higher rates of sulfur dioxide than the prior six eruptions on the Reykjanes Peninsula, you can see why it is not currently open to close viewing from tourists. As a final note, lava effusion rates do truly appear to have decreased in the last 3 days, which is reflected by the trend shown in this volcanic tremor chart.